of Bascom's girls live in the mill boarding house. If you're late,
that's right.
Well, I guess we're both out of a job.
Had your supper?
No.
You want to eat out on the pier?
I ain't hungry.
You don't come to Carousel too much. Only seen you a couple times for today.
Been there much more than that, Mr. Bigelow.
Oh, is that right? You got a sweetheart?
No.
Oh, now, don't lie to me.
Well, I haven't anybody.
Come on, now. You stayed here with me. You know your way around, all right?
No, I don't, Mr. Bigelow.
What would you stay for, anyway?
So you wouldn't be left alone.
Alone?
You are dumb. I don't ever have to be left alone. I can get any girl I want. Don't you know that?
Well, that's not why I stayed.
Oh, well, then you can go right on home.
Is that you, Miss Jordan?
Yes, Mr. Bascom.
Whatever are you doing out at this hour?
Well, I was...
Now, you know what time we close our doors at the mill boarding house? You couldn't get home on time now if you ran all the way.
No, sir.
Those old sideburns.
Here now, don't you go to calling me names. Unless you're fixing to get yourself into trouble. Police tell me they got a report on this fella from New York. They say he's a pretty sly gazebo. Come up here from Coney Island. Makes a specialty out of young things like you. Gets you all moony, and then takes your money.
Well, now that ain't exactly how it goes.
Well, I ain't got any money.
Now, Julie, you're a girl of little experience, and you're all alone in this world. That's why I'm inclined to give you a second chance. Now, I'm meeting Mrs. Bascom at the church. We'll drive you home. I'll explain everything to the house matron.
I ain't all alone. I got my cousin Eddie I can always stay with.
Come, child. Well, don't just stand there like you didn't have good sense.
Do I have to go?
No. No, of course you don't have to.
Then I'll stay.
After I just warned you? Well, there are some of you girls just can't be helped. Good night, Miss Jordan.
Good night, Mr. Bascom.
Good night, Mr. Bascom. I got no folks either. I might have a father somewhere, I don't know. Don't matter too much.
Ain't you scared of me?
No, I mean after what old Sideburn said about me taking money from girls.
I ain't scared.
That's your name, Julie? Julie something?
Julie Jordan.
Julie Jordan. You're a queer one, Julie Jordan. Ain't you sorry that you didn't run away? Now you can still go. If you wanna.
Here to choose to stay. You couldn't take my money if I didn't have any, and I don't have a penny, that's true. But if I did have money, you couldn't take any, cause you'd ask and I'd give it to you.
You're a queer one, Julie Jordan. Ain't you ever had a fella you give money to?
No.
Ain't you ever had a fella at all?
Mm-mm.
And you must have had a fella you went walking with.
Yes.
Where'd you walk?
Nowhere special I recall.
On the beach?
No.
In the woods?
No.
Did you love him?
No. I never loved no one. I told you that.
Sure, a funny kid. You want to go into town? Dance, maybe?
I have to be careful.
What?
Of my character. See, I'm never gonna marry. I'm never gonna marry. If I was gonna marry, I wouldn't have to be such a stickler. But I'm never gonna marry, and a girl who don't marry has got to be much more particular.
Well, now, supposing. I mean, just supposing.
that I was to say to you that, that I'd marry you.
You?
Oh, that kind of scares you, don't it? You think about old Sideburns said.
No, I ain't. I never paid no mind to what he said.
But just the same, you wouldn't marry anybody like me, would
yes,
you?
Yes, I would if I loved you. Wouldn't make no difference what you were, even if I died for it.
Well, now, how do you know what you'd do or how you'd feel if you loved me or anything?
Well, I don't know how I'd know, but just the same, I know how I... How would it be if I loved you? When I worked in the mill, weaving at the loom, I'd gaze absent-minded at the roof. And half the time the shuttle would tangle in the threads and the warp would get mixed with the woof. If I loved you.
But you don't.
No, I don't. But somehow I can see just exactly how I'd be if I loved you. Time and again I would try to say all I'd want you to know.
You don't love me. I mean, that's what you're saying.
Yes. I can smell them. Can you? The blossoms. The wind brings them down.
Well, there ain't much wind tonight. Hardly any. You can't hear a sound. Not the turn of a leaf, nor the fall of a wave hitting the sand. The tide's creeping up on the beach like a thief, afraid to be caught stealing the line. I start to wonder what life is all about.
And I always say two heads are better than one to figure it out.
Yeah, well, I don't need you to help me figure it out. All figured out for myself. We ain't important. What are we? Just a couple of specks or nothing. Look up there. There's a hell of a lot of stars in the sky. And the sky's so big, the sea looks small. And two little people, you and I, we don't count at all.
You sure are a funny, funny kid.
I don't ever remember meeting anyone like you before.
You trying to get me to marry you?
No.
Well, then what's putting it into my head? You're different. You're different. I don't know what it is, but you look at me with that little kid face of yours like you trusted me. I wonder what it'd be like.
What?
Nothing. Nothing. I know what it'd be like. It'd be awful. I can just see myself. Kind of scrawny and pale, picking at my food, and lovesick like any other guy. I'd throw away my sweater and dress up like a dude in a dickie and a collar and a tie if I loved you.
But you don't.
No. No, I don't. But somehow, I can see just exactly how I'd be if I loved you. Time and again I would try to say, all I'd want you to know. Circles I'd go, longing to tell you, but afraid and shy, I let my golden chances pass me by. Soon
blossoms are just coming down by themselves. It's their time to, I reckon.
I don't know. I think a man could make something of himself, even if he was born poor, born ignorant. But he can get to be somebody if he wanted to, if he had a reason to. Maybe. What do you think?